sounds good.
What's up, ladies? Welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl, Lorna Marie. Today I have a pantry organization video for you. I am super excited because it was a hot mess before and I am absolutely obsessed with organizational videos like containers, compartments. I don't know if it has anything to do with being a Virgo, but I'm literally like an organization freak. So this is definitely one of my favorite videos to film. So if you like these videos and you want to see my pantry organization video, then just keep watching.
Okay, you guys, so here is my pantry. I am not proud of it, but here it is. We just moved across the state and literally shoved everything that belongs in here in the shelves and on the floor. Oh my gosh, this is horrible. Yes, we lived like this for 2 weeks straight. But today is the day. It's over. I'm not gonna live like this anymore. Are you ready to go with me on this journey to get my pantry organized? Because I know I'm ready. First, what I like to do is start off by taking every single thing out of the area that I'm gonna be reorganizing. And I like to organize things by category. So I put like appliances, food, and it helps me see what I need to put back in, what kind of containers I need. And also, of course, you have to try everything in the pantry to make sure it's not stale. How did I end up with 3 boxes of Cheerios? I have no idea, but somehow I did. Oh, and those are not stale. Okay, maybe stale. I guess they're good enough to keep. And then I'm just gonna keep unloading whatever I have and sampling as we go. It's really important. All right, now I'm taking out all the containers. This is all of my baking stuff, baking containers, and I literally have too many. My husband wanted to kill me. He's like, you are buying too many of these containers. Did I care? No, but now I'm left with a bunch of XOXO. No, that's not the name. XOX. No, OXO. Yeah, OXO containers. And now I have an abundant amount of them. So I'm gonna try to downsize. That's one of the things I'm gonna try to do while I'm reorganizing my pantry. Okay, so what I'm also gonna do is take out all of the random crap that I don't use. I'm tired of going into my pantry, trying to find something, and it's just everything I don't need. Okay, so this is my kitchen with all the crap in it. Isn't it beautiful? So all this has to go back in there. Obviously, it's not gonna fit correctly unless we organize and purge. So next, I'm gonna be scrubbing these shelves. We're scrubbing these shelves down, making sure they're nice and clean before we start putting everything on top of them. Okay, next I'm taking these baskets that I got from Target. These are going to the bottom of my pantry and they're gonna house everything that I don't need on a daily basis. So it's gonna be extra baked goods, Ziploc bags, garbage bags, extra lunch stuff, the kids' lunch pails, just everything that I don't need to look at or get to every single day. Now I got these ones from Target and I absolutely love them. They happen to fit perfectly. And they're super easy to wipe out. I used to have those ones that are like made out of baskets and it did not work out. Any spills and it was just a hot mess. Okay, so next I'm putting in these containers, which this is my favorite part. It's like Tetris. I absolutely love putting everything back in, trying to figure out which containers go into what. And you'll see me here trying to figure things out. I move things around and I kind of, you know, have this thought process on where things are gonna go, how easy is it gonna be for my kids to grab these items. So first I'm placing all these containers on this bottom shelf here. I'm thinking this is gonna be where my kids' stuff goes. So I start loading all of my kids' snack stuff. This is their favorite, pirate booty. And I kind of like to be OCD here. I like placing everything to make it look really nice and have everything face forward. Okay, so from here, I'm just gonna continue to take all the items I have and put them into containers that fit them the best with the least amount of dead space possible. Okay, next I'm gonna be taking all of the loose food items like chips, cereal, and I'm gonna be putting them into these containers. I will have everything that I used linked in the down box below, so check it out, girl. And of course you have to try some to make sure it's not stale or poison. Okay, so now back to this Tetris thing. I'm just kind of playing around here, seeing where things fit. Okay, so next up, I'm gonna be using these risers. I really, really like these because they help you take up the dead space that would normally be there if you didn't use them. And I also like stacking bins or containers that take up the dead space as well, like these ones right here that hold the Pop-Tarts. They just really help utilize all the space that you have available. Next, I'm gonna be just trying to organize everything with like items. This is like my baked goods and my condiments on top. I'm getting ready to move those. So these hooks are amazing. They're by Command Strips and you put them on the wall and they hold all of your brooms and dustpans and all that. And you just push it right in and they don't damage the wall, which that's kind of a lie though. They do damage your wall a little bit because I've done it multiple times and they have gotten damaged. But anyways, I still use them. They're easy and they just stick right up there without putting holes in the wall. Okay, so next I'm making labels for my baskets. These are just frames that I got from the dollar store. I took all the pieces out and now I'm gonna spray paint them the color I want. I use silver. You can use whatever color you like. And I love this spray paint. I'll link it down below. I got it off of Amazon. I literally used one coat and they dried so fast. And it was the prettiest coat of paint. Cause you know, when you use crappy spray paint, it's just the worst. So then I'm taking everything out of the frames and I break that piece off the back. And that's what I did before I spray painted them. So after I spray paint, they're fully dry. I'm gonna print my labels off on the computer. And you can do whatever you need to print. This is totally customizable. That's why I love it, because I have two condiment baskets. God knows why we need that many condiments, but we do. And now I'm just gonna put all the pieces back together and stick it back into the frame. You kind of have to play with it because of the papers. My paper was a little bit thick, so I had to take one of the pieces of cardboard out to put it back inside. But just play with it and you'll figure it out what works to fit back inside the frame. All right, there we go, extra condiments. So then what I'm gonna do is take my basket and I'm gonna put some hot glue on the back of it. And that's why we ripped off that stand that's on the back of it normally. Okay, so then I apply a generous amount of hot glue. Make sure you put enough hot glue. You don't want that bad boy popping off every time you get into your basket. And make sure it just, you stick it on there really, really well. It's important. And then I'm gonna put this basket back into the pantry and voila, it looks so beautiful. I love it. It's crisp, it's clean, it's exactly the way I wanted it to look. So here's a tour of inside some of my baskets. I have my kids' lunch stuff, their baking stuff. I have extra napkins and I put all the extra boxes like from Costco of all the snacks I have in the other basket on the left there. And then underneath those three baskets, I have extra juice boxes, our stevia soda. I have, what else do I have in there? Ziploc bags, garbage bags. And then also, I wanted to show you guys, I made these stickers. I did them individually. I got them from Michael's, but I really like the way that it turned out. So you can print them on the computer also. So here's the before, you guys. I know it was so scary and not proud of it, but that was the before. Those days are old. And look, the after. It's so beautiful. It feels so good. I truly feel like It's an energy. Every time you wake up, when you go into that kitchen, you want to have a good energy, especially to start your day. And I start my day every day in the kitchen. So this energy translates to everything else that I have going on in my life. And it just feels so amazing. So I'm definitely glad to say that my pantry is done and it's organized and it's beautiful and it is ready to go.
All right, that was my pantry organization video. I hope you guys liked it. Mostly, I hope you guys can take some of those tips and tricks into your own pantry. And if you are my fellow organizing friend, then make sure you hit the subscribe button because there'll be more videos just like this. And if you like the video, definitely give it a thumbs up because that tells me to keep on doing videos like this. Thanks again so much for watching. I know you could be watching anything else, but you're here with me and I so appreciate it. Take care, you guys.